Jabari, Fury, or my jacuzzi.
What's the meaning of jacuzzi?
I met this white kid one day who had a friend named Jabari, and he always said he put his Facebook name is my jacuzzi or jacuzzi Jabari jacuzzi, some shit like that. So when I was making my Instagram, I just thought about it. And I don't know, I've always wanted my own jacuzzi, so it was like my jacuzzi. And then there's a rapper named Ronnie Mai from Baton Rouge, and I just like the word Mai in a name, so yeah, my jacuzzi.
What are the reactions from having the name jacuzzi?
It gets me girls, but I think I get girls with myself. They're like, is that your real name? I say, yeah. Sometimes I say my real name is Boo, and they're like, this is a better name, blah, blah, blah. I don't know. People like it.
What is your age?
I am 16.
Where are you originally from?
Texas, but then I was raised in South Central, and then I was raised in New Orleans and Lafayette.
People become demons on Xanax if you do
nothing. I know.
But if you do some, you can like fix your anxiety. You don't care. So it feels like it's not like for people actually.
That shit is different strokes for different folks. Xanax is a crazy one, man.
So you spent the majority of your childhood in where?
Louisiana.
When did you move then?
I moved to New York when I was 18 because I was bored in Louisiana and just knew I was cooler than that, basically. I was doing great and bad at the same time in Louisiana, so I thought I could do that here too.
Do you still talk to people from home?
My little brother lives there now, so I talk to him. My best friend since kindergarten, he just got stabbed 13 times, once in his eye, once in his heart, and shit, that's pretty much all that matters. He's not dead though.
You still talk to your parents from back home?
My mom's in LA right now. I talk to her once in a while. But yeah, once in a while.
What the fuck?
Where did your mom originally come from?
My mom is from Seoul, Korea. She was born in Seoul. She lived there until she was like 2, I think. She doesn't really know. But she was just in the adoption agency at the moment. And so my grandma had to take her out to move to America. She moved to Texas with my grandma and her stepdad. And yeah, she just lived there for a little bit with my aunts and shit. So I don't know why, like people say I have an Asian fetish. I'm like, no, I'm part Korean. So I use that for that. But like my mom is pretty much, she looks full Korean and my grandma is Korean. And I was raised around only them and my sisters. So like I'm black, but I really feel more of a connection to being Korean. And like, her food is so good. Like, she can cook like the best kimchi, like bibimbap, like japchae, like all that. So, I don't know. I would just watch anime and look at my grandma a bunch and like, yeah. Do I look sober?
Wait, are you in love with me?
Yeah. But like, I don't know what that really is. It's almost
it. Are you gonna move to China?
I would do whatever you want, actually. I'd move anywhere. It's like that. Like, imagine her liking me. It's like that.
She is.
Your mom's full Korean?
No, she's black and Korean. Her dad was like a soldier dude, and my grandma was a prostitute.
Where did they meet?
Probably like, I don't know where prostitutes meet people, like fucking street and like a brothel, fucking something like that. I don't know.
So did you know your grandfather or did he just stay?
No, we all said he died. I think he died. My other one's dead too, but he's dead. They're both dead.
What about your dad's side?
He's dead.
Your dad?
Yeah.
What about his parents also?
She's a pastor. His dad's a pastor too. But he's dead.
Did you have anything planned for when you came here?
I had no idea. I didn't even know where I was living. We just got here and then like called my friends, like relatives, and we found somewhere.
And how do you feel like that compares to now?
A lot of people know me, I still don't know anyone.
When did you lose your front teeth?
When I was 11. I'm actually missing two. Like, but you can't tell. Because I got hit by an escalator and like smashed my jaw together, so it looks like one. And I was just like running across the street. I always would run across the street, blah, blah, blah. And then one day, I was just like running across the street. My friend like, no, you can't do it. I'm like, dude, I got this. And I ran across the intersection. It was a 4-lane street. And then when I got to the third lane, I saw Escalade smack. And then I was knocked out. I woke up in an ambulance. They asked me where I lived. And I was homeless, so I said, I live nowhere. And then, yeah, I went to the hospital. I broke my neck, broke my spine, broke my nose. I had a crack in my skull. And I had internal bleeding. And it was sick.
And what do you think attracts you to the people that you surround yourself?
The people who try to break the standard of what people think is cool or safe or whatever. And people who just try to be them, whether it's like something they found or something, whatever. It's just like they actually genuinely like being what they're being. Not for anybody else.